Alright, it's Chen Chen here, and for today's topic, we're going to talk about build your network, build your empire. So simple say is that a lot of people will talk about is actually your network is your net worth. So when coming to real estate development, actually for this topic, we are talking about the influencer and the context that you have. So it's about you need to create and maintain a healthy network that surround yourself with a lot of people that a business community. So when you talk about net worth, actually you're gonna get involved in your community because people just naturally tend to help out and support people they like, they respect and trust. You're gonna join some community, maybe it's any lottery clubs, Kawanese club or Lion clubs, like any club you can go and join and knows a lot of people. Even though some church and religious related service organization also available and in need for volunteer worker. So it's a great way for you to serve faith and build out your network of valuable contact also, because before this pandemic, I'm always go to work as the volunteer worker and then with my mentors as well. So at the same time, we can do something good for our society. At the same time, you can learn from the mentor, from my mentor that can teach me about the things that is them. Also, you can go and expand your network as well and find your mentor. So at the same time, you're going to join your local chamber of commerce also, actually especially like a business community as well, because you can learn a lot, not a business person, and you can find your mentor as well. So a lot of people, there's much more prefer if you can join real estate industry community. So it seems like it's also that you can join local sales contacts clubs. And then so before you join any clubs or community, you gotta be sure that you get all the facts on membership before giving a pass to any particular club, because even if there's another real estate professional in your desired groups, you may still qualify for membership so that you can look up first any fees you want to pay, everything else, the detail, like who are the people inside there. So when you join the community, actually when you know someone else, actually that's better. You can help your fellow businessman or businesswoman, and then you'll be helping your own career the best way you can. So in the community, if people need help, you go and help them, and at the same time they can help you. So it's like a win-win situation for you to create a harmonious place. So at the same time, if you have certain rate that you're already successful, because just like what Tai Lopez talk about in his 67 step, is you can join the people that actually there's three types of people in our life: the people who is above than us, and then the people who are same level as us, so we can get. So one type of people is the people who are below than us, maybe is younger than you or less experienced than you. So that's whether you can become a mentor. Why we talk about that? Because the best way to learn is teach other, which means that when you have something else, you can teach other people that you already know. It will gain more wisdom for yourself also when you go and teach someone else. So this is the best way you can create a network, and at the same time you can gain your wisdom and then can share it to others also. But there is some step you need to follow, is don't mentor too many people at one time, because you still have business to do, everything else. Just pick the right people and like sharing with them. So you just stay in touch with them, so your advice can be very valuable for them. And then in the same way, also remember your own mentors, like people who teach you before. So you're gonna help your mentors that teach you. At the same time, you can talk with them if they need your help also, anything else, you can help them. So avoid the desire to play puppet master, which means that if the person you mentor them and then they make some mistake, don't use yourself, go and try to help them. You're gonna let them go and fall down and then learn from the mistake themselves so that they can gain, just like riding a bicycle. They go and ride the bicycle after fall down. It's not you go and ride the bicycle again for them, but actually you want them fall down and then get back to it and then keep going on. Just like the baby when learning how to walk, stand up, fall down, stand up, fall down. So after that, they stand up, they can walk already, just like that. So don't hesitate to be tough also when you want to talk to your man, the people you want to mentor. Telling them the truth, not be so kind, everything else, but be kind. You can still telling them the truth that what their mistake is already made or something else. So keep on mentoring, just like always tell the people, because the best way to learn is teach other people so that you can gain more the wisdom that occurring when you teach other. So at the same time, give as well as you get also when you come to the community or you join a network like the club, everything else. So when you already have a network, actually you need maintenance, just like our cars need to maintain, need to take care of your network also. So there's some tips you can follow and then to maintain your network. Is the first is, if you find some clips, stories or article from news media that relevant to your associate business, you can drop them an email or fancy note, or you can direct message them to tell them this benefit for them. So the next is the same also, not just about message them, is someone they need something, that the books, anything you have, so you can help them according to this. You can sharing for them also. It's the same time it's win-win for them. The great value for your network. So the next is the remember their birthday or other important events. You can get phone call, and then nowadays got Facebook, anything else is very easily for you, can have the notice for you. And then if that is their birthday, just call them and say happy birthday or give them a present, anything else. So when you call about the community or you passing to any areas that you have your friends or business associate at there, can set up them with a lunch or breakfast, something else, can have a talk and then maintain the network, maintain the friendship. So if you really like no has any time, but nowadays, especially now pandemic, maybe people have locked down or stay at home as well, you can still make a call and then say hello, are everything good or not, everything well, and then ask for the help, healthy or not, or anything that you help, because still can stay connected. So the last is maybe the most important loop of all is listen, because the best way you can be friend with others or connect with others is you can listen to what they want to say. If they are facing some problem or they are some miserable case happen, you listen to them, you give your ear to them, so that you listen and then you know them, you understand them, you provide. So if you have some advice, can sharing to them also, or just listen to them. It's very important for you to go and maintain your network and then in your community, your friends as well. So a network is a powerful tool, but like any tool, must be keep in condition all the time, otherwise it just won't be able to do the job when it's most needed. So maintain your network, so actually be kind, use your heart to stay away with your community. So a few sort about context, and then there's the context that you need to have is actually variable information come from all type of source, and not them will be chair of the executive committee and the local chamber of commerce. So you're gonna keep contact with your network so that you can always be together and then anything else. Then so the next is the influencer. Influencer is you're gonna find something that who can influence to your business actually. The people nowadays, if we talk about influencer, a lot of what's saying YouTuber, anything else, the people who can influence your project. So you can ask them to talk about you, your project or anything else. They can influence you direct the way that you can do. So these are the few tips that you can look up, and then when you come into the community and build out your network. So lastly, there's some few tips we can read from this book is when you come about the secret of any secret, when you come to want to develop as the real estate developer, the first is you can buy the property to be developed at a reasonable price. Because you pay too much, the deal may never work because your profit getting low already. So the second is be properly capitalized, because development often costs more than budget. Number third is be realistic when estimating the duration of development or rehab time, because it's very easy to underestimate the amount of loan interest your budget. Number four, use escrow and title companies for payment to contractors and subcontractors to ensure that there's no liens on the property. So number five is get properly get advice at each stage of the process. Get your attorney to help you. Number six is surround yourself with experienced contractor and advisor who can lend assistance and help you make the right decision at critical time. Number seven, insist on flexible loan arrangement in case development takes longer and in case you need any additional fund. You can stand by for the cash that you can get the loan or anything else. So number eight, cutting corner leads to problems such as unhappy tenants or buyer who complain about your work product, additional legal and other costs, adverse reputation and municipality problem. So you're gonna cutting them, the people who are negativity. So these are a few tips you can rely on and can stick on it. So that's for today. Hope you like it and enjoy it. See you.